Hey everyone, so here is my full outline, my intro body conclusion for my speech titled The Social Dilemma. So let me know what you think. Is it possible for apps and websites that were created to bring kids entertainment and happiness are actually doing quite the opposite? According to the Pew Research Center, 95% of teens have access to a smartphone and 45% of those admit that they are online almost all the time. I was in high school not that long ago, and I vividly remember the urgency I felt off to get off the school bus, rush to my house, and immediately log into Facebook. I didn't take the time to say hello to my parents, look at my homework, or acknowledge anything else in my life. Checking my notifications was the most important thing. Today, I want to speak with you about what can happen to the young mind if there is too much social media usage, as well as the long-term consequences that can come if these problems are not addressed. Two of the primary issues that adolescents face today are a hindered ability to communicate effectively in face-to-face environment and the prevalence of bullying and feelings of inadequacy. Let's begin with the issue of communication. The ability to communicate effectively is perhaps one of the most important skills young people can acquire. Good communication skills open doors. According to the Department for Children, Schools, and Families, communication is not just about the words you use, but also your manner of speaking, body language, and above all, the effectiveness with which you listen. Though it can be easy to assume that young people are communicating all the time through the use of their keyboard, that logic is only partially true considering what the DCSF stated. With this, essential parts of effective communication are missing, like the interpretation of body language and tone of voice, which cannot be factored in through social media. Young people often thrive on knowing that they are being listened to, whether that is by friends, family members, or strangers on the web. As was similarly stated above, the knowledge that one is truly being heard or listened to comes from the acknowledgement of physical cues, like eye contact, head nods, loving embraces, and etc. Over social media platforms, these essential acts of pure attention are physically impossible to present. And with the fragile nature many adolescents are in, especially in times of trauma, pain, or need, much more than a heart emoji is required to come to a resolution. Bullying via social media has become exceptionally prevalent, but it is extremely difficult to contain and control. Cyberbullying is remarkably easy to participate in, but almost impossible to stop. According to Stop Bullying, all states have laws requiring schools to respond to bullying. Many states do not include cyberbullying under these laws or specify the roles schools should play in responding to bullying that takes place outside of school. What this means is that unless the cyberbullying is taking place between two classmates, there is nothing that can be done to control the problem. Additionally, BBC News covered a story in which they conducted a survey that revealed that 83% of adolescents wish that social media companies would do more to intervene to tackle the problem. Cyberbullying is extremely sophisticated in that almost anyone can participate in it. They can remain anonymous and the content that can remain on the web permanently once published. Because of the complex nature of cyberbullying, victims that contract feelings of depression or fear as a result of it have very little control in stopping the problem. The feelings that can come as a result of cyberbullying attacks can negatively impact children's productivity in school, decrease their self-esteem, and encourage the development of a plethora of other psychologically distressing feelings. I've only scratched the surface, but I hope that I have made it clear just how devastating the results of an abundant use of social media can be in the lives of adolescents. The society of our nation's young people would not be what it is today without the presence of social media. These kids would not have the ability to keep in contact with those that are important to them, make new friends, become familiar with what is going on in the world, etc. However, these kids are also much more prone to verbal and emotional distress based on what they see on their social media, are consistently distracted from what is really important in life, and have a hard time communicating effectively face-to-face. Though social media can be so useful and entertaining, it is going to inhibit the development of quality communication skills and increase the risk of bringing cyberbullying to fruition in the lives of our young people if it is not controlled and put as a lower priority than those things that really matter. And that's what I have so far. So let me know what you guys think. Please, I welcome any critique or any advice on how to improve, but I hope you guys enjoyed it. Thank you.